Hello everyone, now we get into one interesting topic on leveling, curvature and refraction correction. We all learned during our school days that Earth's surface is not flat, instead it is curved. In leveling, curvature correction comes into picture due to the curved nature of the Earth's surface. To understand better, let's get into the field. So, here is your instrument station, and if you keep your leveling staff at starter distance, then no need to account for curvature effect as your line of sight is almost straight. But if leveling is done between two stations at longer distance, then curved nature of Earth has to be considered. Here, line of sight is not parallel to the mean Earth surface. Before getting into the next phenomena, let me tell you something. I guess you remember the reason behind this broken pencil effect. If not, let me recollect. When the light rays travel through differently densed medium, that is air and water, here its velocity varies and hence it bends. As a result, our pencil got broken effect. This is refraction. Similar phenomena is observed in leveling as well. In the atmosphere, as the air density differs and the line of sight which was straight otherwise bends due to refraction, hence your staff reading is lesser than actual. Let us see how to calculate curvature and refraction correction. Fine, I am exaggerating the figure for your easy understanding. So, this is your mean Earth surface. Your instrument is kept over here at a distance D. Your leveling staff is also kept. Let A be your instrument station at which height of instrument is being taken. And a leveling surface is passing through the height of instrument is drawn over here. At P, you can see the level surface intersects the leveling staff and here you are supposed to take the staff reading. But as line of sight is a straight line, you could observe leveling staff only at C. Hence, the segment BC is the error to be deducted. Also, due to refraction effect, the line of sight bends and reaches the staff reading at E finally. So, to get the staff reading corresponding to B, we need to apply correction. Here, BC, CE are corrections due to curvature and refraction respectively, shortly as CC and CR. Let O be the center of the Earth and R be its radius. Now you can see a right triangle nicely formed over here. As you can see, in triangle OCA, OC square is equal to OA square plus AC square. Just split OC as OB plus BC. Hence, OB plus BC the whole square is equal to R square plus D square. Here, OA is directly taken as radius. As height of instrument is negligible compared to Earth's surface, so R plus CC the whole square is equal to R square plus D square. Do not neglect CC as that is what we need to derive over here. Just expand the above equation. R square plus CC square plus 2RCC is equal to R square plus D square. cc square plus 2rc is equal to d square, as r square on either side cancel over each other. So if you take cc commonly outside, then cc into cc plus 2r is equal to d square. So cc is equal to d square by cc plus 2r. Again, ignore cc on the right hand side denominator comparing to earth's radius. Hence, cc is equal to d square by 2r. As you know, mean radius of earth is 6370 km approximately. So, substituting this value, we get cc is equal to 7.85 into 10 power minus 5 d square, and you will get cc in terms of kilometer from this equation. Above equation. If you need cc in terms of meter, then multiply right hand side of above equation with 1000. So cc is equal to 0.0785 into d square. Generally, refraction correction is taken as CR is equal to 1/7 of curvature correction. So, CR is equal to 0.0112 d square. Finally, combined correction is 0.0673 d square. If you need actual staff reading, then it is given by observed staff reading plus CR minus CC. Fine. If you feel these numbers and units are confusing, I suggest you to remember this concept with figure. And finally, cc is equal to d square by 2r, cr is 1/7 of cc, actual staff reading can be calculated as observed staff reading plus cr minus cc.